Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Today, a spring training matchup between the Toronto Blue Jays and the New York Yankees. It's going to be a premier pitching matchup. Two of the league's hardest throwers go head-to-head next. Gerrit Cole, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
And now in the box, Santiago Espinal. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. Swing and a liner. But this will be pulled in out there in left center. Well hit, but a rough out number one.
The second baseman, Kevin Biggio.
So one down, no one aboard, and that'll bring in Kevin Biggio. Into the corner and slicing foul.
Just not able to let that breaking ball travel enough right there. You could see his eyes light up when that popped out of the pitcher's hands, and he just hooked it foul.
And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Into the box now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2 one more time. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now the payoff pitch home. Smoke toward the hole. Throw in time, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. Blue Jays nothing. Yankees coming to bat on MLB Network. Kevin Gausman, the native of Colorado, gets the start on the mound. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Gausman's a guy that can sink the ball pretty well. His mid-90s fastball, his best out pitch is that split finger. He's kind of been a guy that's bounced around between the starting rotation and back to the bullpen. It's never been a question about his arm. Former first-round draft pick by the Baltimore Orioles. If this guy's throwing strikes, he can be awfully tough to hit.
So stepping in is DJ LeMahieu. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch.
Well,
he's only four pitches in, but he doesn't look too sharp to start the day off.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by, but on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
Next for New York, Gleyber Torres. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. Skied down the left field line. Long run for the left fielder. And he makes the catch in the corner.
Batting third, the right fielder, Aaron Judge.
Here's big Aaron Judge. His career numbers against Kevin Gausman. He's gone 2-for-8. He's also been a strikeout victim 6 times. LeMahieu, base runner at first with 1 out. And there he goes toward second. Pitch is a called strike. The throw, not in time. He's in there at second. So he swipes second successfully, but you have to wonder now if that might actually end up taking the bat out of the hands of one of their better hitters.
Well, that's a good point, Matt, but I'd be a little surprised if that's the case. It's still early and the game is tied, so that would be a pretty cautious move to pitch around him here or just walk him flat out.
A ball and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Gurriel is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number 2.
Batting four.
And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. First opportunity for him here with the leadoff man still standing at second. 2 gone now. 1-1. Here it is.
Oh, that's upstairs.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
I got to count 2-2.
Three balls and 2 strikes to the Yankees DH. Luke Voit would be next. Runner in scoring position at second with 2 down. And that misses for ball 4.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in here. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
So now here is Luke Voit looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. The set and the 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
3-1, here it is. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. And he fouls this one off. The payoff pitch. And he misses again. Ball 4. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Here's Joey Gallo now, and a golden opportunity here to give his guys the lead with 3 men aboard. Two and one, here it is.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
2 out, bases loaded. Oh, and it misses ball 4, and that will force home a run.
Man, it's been an absolute nightmare start to the game, and the nightmare continues as he walks in a run here in the first. The wheels are not completely off the bus, but they're definitely wobbling. We'll see if he can limit the damage going forward.
Digging in now for the Yankees, Gio Urshela. And the Yanks trying to make this first inning even sweeter here. The set and the 1-1. And he takes very close to the inside corner here. 2-2, though.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
2-2 pitches fouled away.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question.
Three. Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Yankees forced to settle for one. Second inning upcoming here in Florida's baseball city. The Yankees lead it 1-0. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring forth the slugging shortstop, Bo Bichette. Now the 3-2 pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball. Again, another foul ball. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You could just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
Standing in now, Teoscar Hernandez. And that fastball is too much for him there, 1-2.
You know, when you're facing a top-of-the-line pitcher like this, he's going to be down around the knees like that more often than not. The key is punishing whatever mistakes he makes, but so far he hasn't made many.
The 1-2 is at the knees and called strike three.
Every pitcher looks to get off to a good start. I'd say he's off to a good start. How about the first five batters he's faced? Three of them he sent down via the strikeout.
To the plate now, George Springer. Yankees lead this 1-0 here in inning number two. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out the side in order. So a pitching clinic there as he sets him down in order, all via the punch out. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Half of the second set to go, and digging in is the outfielder Mason Williams. Fouled off. The next 1-2 pitch.
Nope.
To two balls and two strikes now. And it's fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Sent on the ground out to second, right to him. And there's one away.
Batting ninth, the catcher, Gary Sanchez.
And now here is Gary Sanchez. His career numbers against Kevin Gausman, he's just 1-for-6. Here's the 1-1. Just ball off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. 2-2.
Hey, without question, he got him leaning out over right there. Four pitches away, I'd be diving out over the plate as well. And then he dominates him on the inside corner. Nice pitch.
fouled away.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
2-2, here it is. Bases are empty, one man out. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
He's definitely going to want to get greedy in his zone, and he's obviously seeing the ball well, or he would have swung at that pitch. Sometimes in these long, epic at-bats, you start to get into swing mode.
And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at-bat. And there's a base hit on the line. Around first, he's digging for second. And he'll pull into second with one away. Just an absolute laser that time, screaming off the bat, if you will. And Showtrack tells us it went out at 112 miles an hour. Those are the line drives you can hear as they go by. So now to the plate, DJ LeMahieu, and he fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
At the plate, Gleyber Torres.
That's ball two.
Two balls and a strike.
That's
a
ball
slider
three.
That time that runs away. It's 3-1 now. Aaron Judge would be next. Two out here and a runner at second. Swing and a miss at the splitter, 3-1, and it's 3-2 now.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him lay one in on the next pitch there with a base open to work with.
Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Ready now is Lourdes Gurriel. His career line against Gerrit Cole. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. Here comes the 1-2.
Yep, that ball went out.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Here now the 2-2. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Another try at 2-2. To the left side, but it's well foul. 2-2 count, here it comes. And this is swung on and missed. 5 quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Boy, he's really on a roll on the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
In now, Kyle Seager. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
That's a fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
3-ball count right now, this looks like the best chance of getting a base runner on so far.
There's ball four.
That's out.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
The batter will be Alejandro Kirk. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Here comes the 1-2. Misses, ball two.
Man, this at bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Hit the other way out toward right field. Judge is on the move. He gets there, and that's the second out. Coming forward now, the Toronto designated hitter, Santiago Espinal. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at bat.
And that was one of the hardest hit balls they've had all game, Matty. It's been a pretty feeble effort by his teammates on the offensive side.
And it's 2 balls and a strike to the Jays leadoff batter. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
His heater's got some late ride through the zone. A lot of late swings right now. You're only going to get to that pitch if you get the front foot down early.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. This one's blooped out toward right center field. And that's the first hit in this one for the Blue Jays.
The batter number 8. Second baseman, Kevin Biggio.
Stepping in now, Kevin Biggio.
Nope.
Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Fouled off. Two and two. Here it is. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
He set the payoff pitch. And strike three called as he says, "You got to be kidding me," with the side retired. Blue Jays leave a pair. They're down 1-0. Bottom of the third now, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Aaron Judge. Smoked on the ground left side, and that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
Standing in now, Giancarlo Stanton. I think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two. And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. But this'll land untouched. Another 2-2. Hit hard towards center, and that's in there. Base hit. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning.
Danny, how frustrating is this right here? First and third, you got problems all over the place.
Well, you come right out the dugout, right? You're starting an inning fresh. You're expecting to have a 1-2-3 inning. You look up, and all of a sudden, first and third, nobody out. It's time to make some good pitches.
Into the box, Luke Voit. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. With 2 strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
pretty good spot to be in as a pitcher right now. You can go for the punch out or try to deuce the ground ball to get a double play.
Ready with the 1-2.
That ball too.
Runners are at first and third with none out. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Hard hit ball to second, and that's through. A base hit. And to score, the runner from third.
Now back.
So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll hope to settle this guy down. At the plate now, Joey Gallo. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
It's not easy to continue pounding the strike zone when you've given up three consecutive hits, but he has to trust that getting the ball down in the zone will get him an out.
All even now, 2-2. From the stretch. And he popped him up. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. 2-2 one more time. Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. He's got it. One there. But the return throw will be too late, and the run is in to score. On to first, but not in time. It's a fielder's choice and an RBI.
Well, they really didn't have a shot at turning two on the high chopper. They only get one, and that allows the runner from third to score.
Yankee shortstop behind in the count, 1-2.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. And indeed, he won't try to force it at second. He'll just flip on to first for the sure out. Next to stand in is Mason Williams, runner in scoring position with two gone. And that's into the corner, a foul ball in right. Gallo at second with two down. And it's fouled away. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
That's a ball.
Yeah, and that splitter is normally the go-to pitch to this guy, but it really hasn't shown that good downward action that he usually has. He needs to get back to finishing it out front.
Here now the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Three innings complete. It's the Yankees 3, the Jays nothing. Luis Severino will come out now and make his first appearance of the spring.
Number 40, Luis Severino.
All set for the start of the fourth. And next, the dangerous power threat, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Judge is on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
Now batting.
So one out and nobody aboard. And in the bat next, the legacy, Bo Bichette. No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the game for Toronto. Hit back up the middle, and that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, ripped a base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
To the plate now, to Oscar Hernandez. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Williams is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. Stepping in for the Jays, George Springer struck out in his first at bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one, and we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
And he'll dive back in safely. Maybe too much break on the slider. Two and one.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Changeup laid off down around the shins.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Three balls and two strikes to the Blue Jays center fielder.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Ripped down the line, and that's through for a base hit. Make him one for two in this one. Now a long throw home. But this won't be in time as he's well safe and the run scores. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
So now to the plate, Lourdes Gurriel. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone. Working for the punch out and the offering. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Hit ball to second. Throw on to fourth takes care of him, and the inning is over. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Yankees 3 and the Blue Jays 1. Jose Berríos, a right-hander standing 6 foot even, will take over the pitching duties here.
Number 17, Jose Berríos.
Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. Now the 3-2 pitch. Bounce to first. He's right there, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now batter.
So back to the top of the Yankee order. Digging in, DJ LeMahieu. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Swing and a miss. Got him with the slurve there. Two gone.
Now back.
So two are gone now in the Yankee half of the fourth, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder Gleyber Torres. The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two.
A
couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Here comes the 1-2.
Two balls.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Hit on the ground to short. Bichette's got it. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3, and it's still 3-1. Michael Wacha, a right-hander standing 6'6", will take over pitching duties here.
Number 52, Michael Wacha.
New inning set to get underway, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Kyle Seager. Not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Shows some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
Stepping in now, Alejandro Kirk. A 1-2 count to the Blue Jays signal caller. Seager gets his lead at first, nobody out. Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
Now back.
And now back to the leadoff spot in the Blue Jays lineup. Stepping in, Santiago Espinal. A hit in two tries so far. In the dirt, and now let's see. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, I know what he was thinking there. The pitch before was way out of the zone, and he was hacking. So the pitcher says, hey, if he's going to swing at that, how about this? Solid strategy, except this time it didn't work out, and it's a wild pitch.
Three to one our score as we play inning number five. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup.
After fouling off the second one, I got to step out of the box, adjust my batting gloves, and tell myself there's no chance he's tripling up on that pitch.
The 2-2 pitch. You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
Just tied him up with that last pitch. Pretty evident by the swing. Sometimes guys get in that protect mode so much that they're swinging at everything that they see, and they end up offering it pitches that they can't possibly do anything with.
Into the box now, Kevin Biggio, fouled away. Another 2-2 offering.
Three balls, two
strikes. Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And this one is gone, a home run. A two-run blast to straightaway right field, and the Blue Jays are back to even now, tied 3-3.
Yeah, he was having zero luck early in the game, striking out twice in two at-bats, but it only takes one swing to get back in a groove. That was definitely it.
Into the box, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Count's full.
Hits are now even at four apiece. Got him swinging. Made him chase outside the zone that time, and that puts an end to the inning. Jays strike for a couple as you get another look at the two-run dinger. Bottom of the fifth coming up. We're tied now at three apiece. Trevor Richards, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Number 35, Trevor Richards.
Stepping in once again is Aaron Judge. His prior history versus this arm, he's 3-for-15. He's also been a strikeout victim six times. The 1-1 home.
Ball, that's it.
Wave and a miss made him reach.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline in that. You get a count in your favor and he's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
Ball three. 3-2 now. Don't go too far. The dangerous Giancarlo Stanton gets his shot next. Into center field, line drive, base hit. With that, the Yankees have put their leadoff hitter aboard to start out the inning.
Hey guys, he's not known for being a singles hitter right here, but that's his second knock of the game.
And I'm sure he'll take him, but the guys on the other side of the scorecard might be thinking, we really avoided a worse fate. In now, Giancarlo Stanton. Hit out towards second. That's through for a base hit. He's now 2-for-2 in this one. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
These guys are in perfect position to break through right here and to take the lead. There is, without question, nothing tougher than back-to-back singles. You don't know if they're going to bunt. You don't know. They can do so. They have so many options at their disposal right now.
At the plate, Luke Voit. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. 1-2 now.
After giving up back-to-back hits on two pitches, nice to see him nibble outside the zone to get that swing and strike.
Lays off. 2-2 now.
2-2.
Judge on second. Stanton on at first with nobody out. And a good swing there as this is deep down the line in right, but this is going to wind up out of play. In the dirt, throw over to third here, and oh, they say he beat the throw, safe at third.
Well, you live by the sword, you die by it too. He went with an off-speed pitch down in the zone, and that's the risk you take there. The catcher can't come up with it, and two runners advance. Now they're both into scoring position.
Three runs, six hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Now Voit with a high fly ball out to deep left field. Now a leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, and it's now 6-3.
Oh, and that was really close to a long out. The left fielder had a beat on it, and he gave it a great effort, but he couldn't quite bring it back. Instead, it's a trip around the bases.
Ross Stripling, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. So now to the plate, Joey Gallo. Grounded to first. And he'll step on first himself for the out. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. High in the air out towards shallow right. Hernandez will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning.
Now batter.
Next to hit, Mason Williams struck out in his last trip to the plate. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. High in the air down the right field line. Hernandez is in pursuit. Into the corner, he makes the catch to end the inning. Another look at the big blow for the Bombers, a 3-run home run. 5 innings complete. New York leads it 6-3. Domingo Germán takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Yankees, number 55, Domingo Germán.
All set for the start of the inning, and into bat next, the legacy Bo Bichette. One and two now as that one's fouled off. A breaking ball swung on and missed, and he set down for the second time this afternoon. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
To the plate now, Teoscar Hernandez. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. He takes the turn and heads for second. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double.
Nice adjustment by the batter right there. You cannot fault the pitcher for going to that well again. First one he swings and misses through, and this one the batter's able to execute and drive it for a base hit.
Into the box now, George Springer. Took him right up the ladder that time, and it's 1-2.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Ripped on the ground to first, and he'll take this one to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
Now back.
So a runner at third, two men are out, and that brings up the exciting Lourdes Gurriel Jr. The 2-1.
Inside, ball three.
Kyle Seager would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Here's the 3-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is under it, and the inning is over. Blue Jays held in check. Can't cut into that 6-3 deficit. Nate Pearson enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 24, Nate Pearson.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and now it'll be the catcher, Gary Sanchez. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And some action now in the Toronto bullpen as a right-hander starts to get loose. The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
I really liked it. He gave up nibbling out of the zone trying to get at the chase. That wasn't working, so he just reached back and fired a good old country hardball fastball right by him. No better feeling in the world when you're a pitcher than throwing a fastball right by a guy.
Into the box, DJ LeMahieu. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees' leadoff man.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
One out, nobody on. Now a fastball, and he knocks this one into right center field. That's going to be a base hit.
Up next to the Yankees, the second baseman. Labor. Go red.
At the plate now, Gleyber Torres. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1.
He's going.
He's running.
Going.
Pitch outside. The throw.
He's
not
safe
in time as he steals second. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Standing in now, Aaron Judge.
Ball that time.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. Giancarlo Stanton would be next. LeMahieu stands at second with two gone. Ball
that's
four.
Outside. Ball four.
Now batting the designated hitter.
Giancarlo Stanton now. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. A 1-1. A bouncer to the left side. And the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Yanks strand a pair as they're unable to add to their 6-3 lead. Jack Green is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 57, Jack Green.
Leading off the inning, it'll be Kyle Seager as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Ball, that's out.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
Now batting, catcher.
Next to bat for Toronto, Alejandro Kirk. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. One and two, here it comes. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. Mauricio Dubon will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Big hitting for Toronto. Number one, Mauricio Dubon.
And he'll lay off the fastball down low. It's 2-1 now. Runners on first with one down. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. And it looks like the Yankees will have a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Two out with the man at first. Swing and a miss as the slider sets him down for the final out of the inning. Julian Merriweather will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 67, Julian Merriweather.
Otto Lopez will come on defensively now as he takes over at second.
Otto Lopez.
Gregory Polanco is up off the benches. He'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. Now the 3-2 pitch is in there, a called strike three.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
Anthony Rizzo will come on as a pinch hitter to try and make an impact with one away.
Number 60, Anthony Rizzo.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back Ks, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
So now to the plate, Gio Urshela. A ball and two strikes now.
Hey, find a way right here. Two outs, this guy has come in throwing bullets. If he can get this team into the dugout right here with another donut and they regroup, start passing the baton a little bit, we got ourselves some action.
Count even at 2-2. Trying to strike out the side, here it is.
Three balls, two strikes.
Mason Williams would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Two out, nobody on. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Waiting on it is Hernandez. He handles it easily and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They still lead it 6-3. Jonathan Loaisiga has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 43, Jonathan Loaisiga.
Ryan LaVarnway is going to come on as a defensive replacement now as he takes over at first base. Ryan McKenna is also into the ball game as he'll assume duties in left field.
Ryan McKenna.
Talley is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on a 3-2 count. With a three-run lead, no one on base, this is the perfect situation to do it. No reason to nibble and possibly set up a big inning.
And a good take there will net him a base runner as it's ball four now to start the eighth inning.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Rendell Grichuk will come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out.
Number 16, Rendell Grichuk.
The 2-1 home. It's a breaking ball that's taken for a ball.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in his zone to induce a ground ball double play.
A full count, 3-2 to Rendell Grichuk. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Justin Williams will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning. Talley, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Now a double play ball here as this is on the ground to third. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. It's the Yankees 6, the Blue Jays 3. Talley stays in the ballgame after pinch hitting as he'll take over at first base.
Now playing first base.
Justin Williams stays in the game after pinch hitting, and he'll be patrolling right field. Bowden Francis is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Kevin Smith is also into the game as he takes over at short. And now, Mason Williams. He flew out in his last AB. On, he pops it up. And this is going to be a foul ball. Back up. Oh, no, that got him. But he is able to recover as he gets the out at first. One away now. This has to be a big concern here. This ball came back and got him right in the pitching arm. And that is something you just never want to see. You can see him trying to work this one off. And from all appearances, I think they're going to let him continue. So that at least is a good sign. Stepping in next, Gary Sanchez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Got him swinging, chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Miguel Andujar gets the call as a pinch hitter, and he'll get a chance with two out and the bases empty.
Miguel.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. as they're unable to add to their 6-3 lead. Ladies, Miguel Andujar is going to go ahead and stay in the ballgame and play third down.
For the Yankees, now playing third base.
Aroldis Chapman comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Now pitching for the Yankees, number 54, Aroldis Chapman.
Danny Jansen is going to be asked to try and be the rally starter as he's up off the bench, ready to lead it off in the ninth. Looked like ball four there, but instead it's 3-2 now.
Hoo-wee.
That was some smoke right there. High fire right on by.
And a swing and a miss on the fastball, and there's the first out here in the ninth.
Now batting, the left fielder, Lourdes Gurriel.
Next, it'll be Lourdes Gurriel. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
The count now at 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul. 2-2 one more time, and he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Throw on to first, and now the Jays are down to their final out. Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager. Lifetime line against Chapman. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. And this is swung on and missed. So with that, they find themselves down to their final strike here this afternoon. Final strike for the Blue Jays. And a swing and a miss as they definitely had him reaching for that one. And this ball game is over.
Man, facing Chapman is not for the faint of heart as he unleashes fireball after fireball. Gets the final out here and another save. What a weapon Chapman is.
6-3, the final score today. So the Bronx Bombers used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Michael Wacha pitches well enough to get the W. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Yankees. 6 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For the Blue Jays, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 11 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.